no question about it. The Tennessee fan base is a very passionate one.
Yeah, that passion seems to have hit a peak. And it's a decision which has sparked as much controversy, if not more, than anything I've seen in my nearly 30 years covering Tennessee athletics. The decision to all but eliminate the nickname Lady Vols from the UT brand.
Now moving forward, Tennessee's beloved women's basketball program will still be referred to as Lady Vols. I think it's safe to say that's attributed to the woman who put the name Lady in Vols, Coach Pat Summitt.
I think I can teach young women that, you know, there are no barriers. You go for it. Whatever you want in life, you can go for it. Basketball is a great place to learn.
You look at the arch in this building, you know why they're here? For you. You better make it happen right now.
You can probably trace the rise of the women's game with the rise of her basketball program. So she'll go down as one of the all-time greats in coaching.
And the victories kept coming.
She's been to the Summit three times now.
And Pat Summitt wins the fourth of her sparkling career.
I told her that I want an awesome woman on the locker room so that our teams and our visitors know what is possible for women. There's a lot of powerful women in this room.
The Lady Vols, you are a living legacy.
Lady Vols soccer team is ranked 13th nationally. Friday, Tennessee picked up its fifth straight shutout win, marking the most consecutive shutouts in program history.
Tennessee put itself on the map, not only in the SEC, but nationally today.
Tennessee is going back to the World Series as they eliminate the defending national champs.
You carry the past, you are the present, you create the future.
The decision to power one team coincided with the department's new Nike partnership, but the company's research found that the continued use of Lady Vols further segments an athletic institution that is striving to be united as one Tennessee. Still, there are many who believe it's just a matter of time before the name Lady Vols completely vanishes from the big orange landscape.
And to those out there who feel that the Lady Vols legacy is threatened, would you disagree?
Absolutely. We were separate departments and called Lady Vols, but we're not separate, Rick. And I think the small segment that wants us to go back to being separate, we're not going to do that.
This decision to remove the Lady Vol brand, which is incredibly powerful, people all over the world, you wear a Lady Vol product somewhere in Europe, people know what it is.
We have a backlog of letters we have not gotten to yet. It's been 5 months and we've averaged at least one a day. Ever since. First 4 months, we didn't receive one letter in support of changing the name and changing the logo.
And Laura says those against the change don't mind the merging of the two departments. They just want them to maintain two separate but powerful brands.
The women of this university have given their lifeblood, their sweat. To wipe this away marginalizes the accomplishment of women in this state.
We have to give our best effort moving forward, and I think even with the deadline approaching, people will continue to fight.
Mr. Speaker, today I rise to recognize not only one of the greatest coaches of all time, but also one of the greatest people of all time, University of Tennessee Lady Vols coach Pat Summitt. Yesterday, Coach Summitt was named Sports Illustrated's Sportswoman of the Year, and there was no one more deserving than her. Not only is she the all-time winningest coach in NCAA basketball history with well over 1,000 wins, including 16 SEC titles and 8 national championships, but she is also an exemplary role model for the students she coaches and a shining ambassador for the university she represents. Earlier this year, Coach Summitt was diagnosed with early onset dementia, Alzheimer's type. While the news would be unbearable for many to take at such a young age, Coach Summitt has stayed on the sidelines and continues to coach the Lady Vols. She is again leading by example and showing her players that while life is full of obstacles, you can continue to achieve success through hard work and dedication. Thank you, Coach Summitt. I am glad you represent my alma mater. Go Big Orange.